Protesters in Peru are calling for the president to resign after he pardoned jailed former leader Alberto Fujimori. Large crowds rallied on streets of the capital Lima. They accused current president Pedro Pablo Kuczynski of granting the pardon as part of a political deal to stay in power. Two members of his party have already resigned in protest. Fujimori was serving a 25-year sentence for human rights abuses and corruption before he was released on health grounds.
We are demanding his resignation and the reconviction again of this genocide, Alberto Fujimori. Everyone in the Fujimorist and Aprista groups, really everyone in Congress. The people are within all their rights to unite in the national insurgency.
Well, let's cross over to Mehmet Özkan. He's an associate professor of international relations at Universidad Javeriana. Good to speak to you, Mehmet. So Peruvian leader Kuczynski pardoned Fujimori on health grounds, but was it all actually to save his own skin over corruption scandals as Fujimori's daughter controls the Congress?
I think partly yes, because Alberto Fujimori is a very divisive figure in Peruvian politics, but through his family he still has lots of influence in the Peruvian politics. I mean, if his son Keiko Fujimori and with nine colleagues, if they voted yes, probably Kuczynski today would not have been present in Peru. But his party, I mean, Keiko, his daughter, played a different role, voting against the Kuczynski, and his son Keiko, his son Kenji, sort of played a negative role in sort of negating the impeachment against Kuczynski. So I mean, today, in any case, the family of Fujimori is very influential in Peruvian politics. He's a very divisive figure, and many people like him. At the same time, many people hate him. You know, in the last election, 2016, actually, the whole politics was based on Fujimori. You know, actually, the opposition candidate Keiko Fujimori lost less than, it was lack of 14,000 votes, almost. I mean, many people vote for Kuczynski because his anti-Fujimori stance. But with Kuczynski's pardon today, I think Kuczynski lost his credibility in a way in Peruvian politics. He knows that, you know, in yes. constitutionally in Peru, only one can be 5-year president. So he will try to be more conservative from now on.
And seven other people were pardoned with Fujimori. Was this all carried out on legal basis, though?
Legally, president can pardon because his family already present a case that he's very ill. Actually, you know, Fujimori, he's in hospital right now, and he's very ill. But of course, you know, the pardon is a political decision. It just came after saving his presidency, you know, just 2-3 days after saving his presidency. So it's totally a political decision. In many people in Peru, people talk that Alberto Fujimori himself called some congressmen to vote no to impeachment. I mean, so there's a deal here. In terms of pardoning and the cancelling the impeachment process.
And Mehmet, Fujimori is admired by some Peruvians for combating most rebels, but his critics considered him a corrupt dictator. How would you describe him for Peru?
I think, you know, if you look at the 1990s, you know, he was the person who eliminated Shining Path. I mean, in the 1990s when it was on the rise. And at the same time, I mean, perhaps in that time what he did was correct. I mean, of course, in terms of human rights, he's very debatable. I mean, but I think he's a very divisive figure. I mean, he did something good and something bad. I mean, in terms of 1990s in that context. Of course, what he did later on, you know, killing many people, human rights abuses, it was totally wrong. But given the fact that in his family still has an influential figure in Peruvian politics, I don't think he will have a very good trial. I mean, very, very fair trial, because his family still controls the Peruvian politics.
Well, thank you for that insight there, Mehmet Özkan.